Hello everyone, Dr. Ashwini Shetty, Associate Professor of Annapurna Medical College, Department of Anatomy. So today we are going to discuss on blood supply of heart.
Heart is supplied by two coronary arteries. As you all know, it is a right coronary artery and the left coronary artery. So each artery is a vasovasorum of ascending aorta, because the heart is developed from the primitive endothelial tubes, which represents the ventral aorta. Now here what you can see, this is the right coronary artery. Now the right coronary artery, which is arises from the anterior aortic sinus. Now this is the aorta, so anterior aortic sinus of ascending aorta. Now the artery passes forward between the pulmonary trunk and the right auricle. Okay, the artery passes forward between the pulmonary trunk and the right auricle, then passes downwards and right atrioventricular groove. So here you can see the atrioventricular groove, and then it winds around the inferior border of the heart, then passes upward and it runs behind the posterior part of the atrioventricular groove. Here it is anastomosis with the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery at the crest of the heart. Now the 60% of the subject, the right coronary artery anastomosis with the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. In 10% of the cases, you can see it ends at the inferior border of the heart, and in 20% of the cases, the right coronary artery, it passes entirely posterior part of the atrioventricular groove. Now coming to the branches of the right coronary artery. The right coronary artery has a branch in the first segment as well as the second segment. Now in the first segment, we can see there are ventricular rami, which are mainly supplying to the infundibulum of the ventricle as well as to the right ventricle, and it also has a atrial rami. Now the right coronary artery, it gives in the first segment in the ventral rami, the first branch is the right conus artery. The right conus artery, it is supplying to the infundibulum of right ventricle. Sometime it anastomoses with the conus artery, left conus artery around the infundibulum, and this is called as the annulus vicens. Okay. Next is the anterior ventricular rami. Anterior ventricular rami, which supplies to the sternocostal surface of the right ventricle. And also you have here the right marginal artery. The right marginal artery, which runs along the adjoining surface of the right ventricle. So that is right marginal artery. There are few, you can see here, these are the atrial rami. So the atrial rami of the first segment of right coronary artery. So this atrial rami supplies the myocardium of the heart, that is mainly to the right atrium. Also you have a nodal artery, deeper to that, the nodal artery, which is runs between the right auricle and the root of the ascending aorta and arches laterally in the superior vena cava. It comes in front of the superior vena cava and supplies to the SA node. So they are the nodal artery. Now this is a posterior surface, posterior part on the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. Now here you can see the right coronary artery gives a second segmental arteries. So second segmental branches are posterior ventricular rami, which mainly supplies to the diaphragmatic surface of the right ventricle. Okay, so it supplies to the diaphragmatic surface of the right ventricle, and also it gives one of the very important branch that is called as the posterior interventricular branch, which is arising from the right coronary artery. So you can see here, this is the posterior interventricular branch which is arising from the right coronary artery, and here near the crest of the heart. This is the crest of the heart. Now 70% of the subject, it passes through the posterior interventricular groove close to the apex, and then it anastomoses with the anterior interventricular branch. Sometime in 2 or 3% of subject, the posterior interventricular artery run parallel to one another. Now in 10% of the subject, the posterior interventricular branch, which is arises from the left coronary artery. So based on this, the continuity of the posterior interventricular branch, it is described as either it is a right coronary dominance or the left coronary dominance. Mainly the posterior interventricular branch is mainly, it arises in 80 to 90% of subject, it is arising from the right coronary artery. Now posterior interventricular branch, these provides few branches to the diaphragmatic surface of the right ventricle as well as the left ventricle. So in 80 to 90% of people subject, the AV nodal artery, which is derived from the right coronary artery, and 10 to 20% of subject, it is derived from the left coronary artery. So here we ended with the right coronary artery, the cores and the branches of the right coronary artery. Now coming to the left coronary artery. So you can see here, now this is the arch of aorta. This is ascending aorta, arch of aorta. So in the left coronary artery is wider than that of the right coronary artery, and it supplies the large volume of the myocardium, which is, and this is arising from the left posterior aortic sinus. So you can see here, this is the origin of the left coronary artery. Now this is the aorta. So this is the origin of the left coronary artery. This is the left coronary artery. Now the left coronary artery passes in between the pulmonary trunk. So you can see here, this is a pulmonary trunk, and appears forward, and it is it runs forward in between the, you can see this left coronary artery in between the pulmonary trunk as well as the left auricle. So this is a left auricle, and this is the pulmonary trunk. So you can see it arises from in between the left auricle as well as the pulmonary trunk. Now here it divides into two branches. That is, one is, you can see this branch is called as the anterior interventricular branch. The another branch which runs at the laterally and in the posterior interventricular groove, in the posterior atrioventricular groove. So here it runs along the posterior atrioventricular groove. So that is the circumflex artery. Now anterior interventricular artery is a branch of left coronary artery. It descends corresponding to the correspondence groove along with the sternocostal surface, and it runs along the sternocostal surface in the anterior interventricular groove. You can see here, it runs along the anterior interventricular groove, and then it reaches the apices cordis. So here it gives few branches, that is the branches of the left coronary artery. So here you can see, these are anterior ventricular rami. Okay, anterior ventricular rami, and the left anterior ventricular rami are very prominent, and they are called as a diagonal artery. These are called as, this is large, and it's called as a diagonal artery. There are also some septal ramis which supplies to the ventral anterior superior part of the two-third of the septum, in between, that is interventricular septum. Okay, it supplies to the anterior superior part, two-third of the anterior superior part of the interventricular septum. Now as I mentioned earlier, the left coronary artery, it continues as the circumflex artery. So circumflex artery, it runs along the posterior left atrioventricular groove. Okay, posterior left atrioventricular groove, it accompanies with here with the coronary sinus, and at the crest of the heart, it is anastomosis with the right coronary artery. It anastomosis with the right coronary artery. Now, the circumflex artery, which is a branch, which is a continuation of the left coronary artery, it gives few atrial and ventricular rami. So, you can see these are the ventricular and the atrial rami, which is supplying to the right left atrium and left ventricle. Okay. So, these are the atrial and the ventricular rami, which is supplying to the left ventricle and the left atrium. Also, it gives a sinoatrial nodal artery. So, these are 35% of this, which is arising from the circumflex artery. So, here now you can see the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. This is a circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. So, here this left coronary artery, it also gives the left marginal artery, which is supplying, it is prominent and it is supplying to the left border of the heart. It also gives a posterior interventricular branches. Okay. Then there are few arterial branches, atrial branches of the circumflex artery, which is communicating with the similar artery of the right coronary artery. So they are called as a Kugel's artery. They are called as the Kugel's artery. So summary at the end, the right coronary artery which supplies to the right atrium, the right ventricle, except at the strip along the interventricular groove, and it also supplies to the SA node by the nodal artery and the AV node. The left coronary artery it supplies to the left atrium and the left ventricle, except at the strip along the posterior interventricular groove. So here we ended with the course and the branches of the right coronary artery and the left coronary artery. The most common cause of death across the world is due to the ischemic heart disease. That's because of the occlusion of the blood vessels of arterial or venous drainage of the heart. So these vessels of the heart. So that's why it's very important to know the different courses as well as the supply and the branches of the arteries which are supplying to the heart. Thank you, one and all.